Well, here we have a Katana Fender Squire thing from Japan.
It's pretty nutty looking.
But it has all kinds of ugly little chips all over it, which makes it not very pretty.
Well, makes it less pretty than it already isn't.
And,
I don't know, what the heck kind of a knob is that? Is half of it missing or something? That's weird.
We're gonna play color match.
So, break all boundaries of science here.
So, oh, I got some BG fan noise going on here. Let's turn that off. So, what we'd propose to do, this is TW. Now, the Glue Boost thing could work for this, but there are so many little chips all over it, it would be difficult to mix up a quantity of something close to this using Glue Boost. So I'm going to do a little bit of science. I did some science already with this. So I am going to use the Glue Boost tint, but I'm going to add it to lacquer. And it seems to work out quite well. So just another thing that the, you know, these tints will work on lacquer. So let's make some white. What do I have? Oh, gee, I might have to get... I'm saved! Oh, here it is. In the jar, labeled weed honey, is not weed honey. It is clear lacquer. Through the process of movie magic, I now have two containers of white. There's a reason for that. And I will actually, if I really screw this up, I will need yet another clean glass jar. So what'll happen is I'm going to attempt to get this right. If I get it too dark, then I can add some white back to that. And if I really screw it up, then I can pour all of that back into another jar and keep adding white till I get it right. But that's not the plan. That's not the plan. That's like plan C after you screw it up. And I've always said this about finish repairs. That's the great thing about it, is if you screw it up, well, you just get to take it all off and start over, don't you? Okay, should I wear gloves? I think I will. Okay, let's see how big a mess I can make here. And this is going to be, like, I know this is such powerful shit. And do I shake much? That is probably going to be three times more than what I need. Let's go with just a little crumb to start. All right. Uh-oh. What do we got here? Mr. Toothpick, a.k.a. Mr. Stirstick. And this. I could treat this. Maybe I'll just try that. That really didn't do much after it blended in. Let's add a little more. Like I said, I really don't want to go overboard, because then I'll have to go backwards in time. And I can see, oh, she's starting to turn. But I'm going to have to shake it, I think, to get this right. The lid on that. The last thing you want to do is have that shit flying all over the house. You hear that noise? That's a little glass bead inside the jar to help mix things up. I don't think I'm dark enough even close yet. Well, it's tough to say. I gotta get some better light on this. And just let it sit for a minute. Let it blend in. Let it melt. Just trying to get a little tighter here. Once again, the old popsicle stick, before I actually apply anything to the guitar. But that looks pretty freaking good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a touch up on the back where we don't really, really see too much, and maybe let that dry a bit and see how close I am. What do you think? Sound like a plan?
We'll be using the Alter brush. Size regular.
I don't know. I might have to go a little tinge darker. What do I do? Why did I look inside there and it looks like I saw some tint that wasn't melted in yet?
You guys will be familiar with that motion.
A lot of these are going to take more than one pass anyway. So, see, I think I need to go a little darker. In fact, I need to go way darker. Way, way darker, Davey. But that's okay. Like I said, that's pass one. So, after a little bit of dinking around, it was decided I needed to add a tiny little bit of brown. And I'm doing the old, like I said, popsicle stick comparison, and also trying some on the back. But I don't think I can get any closer than that, guys. I really don't. So, I'm just going to put this aside for a bit. And just because this guitar is so weirdly shaped and there are so many defects, I'm going to take the neck off of it to do this. Right? Quite an interesting pile of neck shimming in here. I'm not going to disturb that. Look, they even got a little Fender logo on their shim. So I think you guys get the idea. If I really wanted to get crazy, I could actually go clear on top of that once I get this, but it's so weird, and that's why it's all chipped, because it's such an obtuse shape. Anyway, Dave's fun with tinting lacquers and making things look better than they did. Cheers, folks. Thanks for hanging out. And all the links to things are below. Special shout out to all my patrons, subscribers, and the Facebook group. Yeah, keep it rocking. You can always Twitter me. And as always, be good to each other. Cheers.